Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our science class. So children, today we are going to discuss about the formation of image by convex and concave lens. Children, we can see different types of images, smaller, bigger, inverted and erect through lenses. A convex lens produces images similar to those produced by a concave mirror, and a concave lens forms images which are similar to those produced by a convex mirror. Convex lens. A convex lens forms both real and virtual images. The nature and size of the image formed depends on the distance of the object from the lens. A magnifying glass is actually a convex lens mounted on a lens holder. When an object is placed between the focus and the lens, it produces an enlarged virtual erect image of the object on the same side of the lens as the object. This is why it is used for reading fine print and to observe tiny things. A convex lens can also create a real image. Real images are projected on a screen or a film of a camera. So children, now let us see the image formation in a convex lens when the object is placed at different positions. First, when the object is very far, that is at infinity, then a real, inverted, diminished image is formed at the focus. Next, when the object is placed beyond focus, then a real, inverted, diminished image is formed on the other side of the lens. Third, when the object is placed between the focus and the lens, that is optical center of the lens, then the image formed is virtual, erect, magnified and on the same side as the object. Next, when the object is placed at the focus, then in this case the image is formed at infinity. Now let us see the image formation in a concave lens. A concave lens always forms an erect virtual image of an object placed anywhere in front of the lens. The image formed is on the same side as the object and its size is smaller than that of the object. Children, there are few points that should be kept in mind while drawing ray diagrams for lenses. First, rays parallel to the principal axis after refraction will pass or appear to pass through the focus. Second, rays passing through the focus after refraction will become parallel to the principal axis. Third, rays passing through the optical center will pass through the lens without bending. So that's all in this video. Thank you.